A local
I
challenger.
I beat kingfish at Bagamo.
That's great. Fantastic. Look at the result. He's still got many pieces. Well, I'll play the runner-up, huh? Can I play the runner-up? The loser. Yeah. I'll play you.
Okay.
Easy. Okay, here we are on Lake Victoria, South Nyanza, Kenya. And this lake is the largest tropical freshwater lake in the world. And everybody around the lakeshore is really reliant on the fishing. And we have good catches of fish here on the lake. And it has an area of 80,000 square kilometers, the lake, and it's not very deep. It's about 250 foot deep at the deepest. So we have Luo tribe living around the lake, and they are very gentle people, and they do fishing mostly, and they use wooden fishing boats, which have been made like that for thousands of years. Myself, I am trying to stop them using trees for making boats. I am a boat builder. I was brought up in Kenya for the first 5 years of my life, and then I was taken to Britain, and I've seen a lot, so I came back here to try to introduce metal boat building, steel boat building, which sounds crazy, but it's not, because this is a freshwater lake. So I am here as an environmental designer. I have a lot of interest in the protection of the fish and showing people the lake, because it's very interesting. There are a lot of strange things happening in the lake. There are animals which people wouldn't think about being here. We have otter, freshwater otters. We have, of course, hippos. We have monitor lizards. We have pelicans. We have lots of birds as well. And we also have Ruma National Park nearby, which is a great little national park, and it's totally unspoiled. It's very natural. And we have the Rothschild giraffe, huge giraffes there. But we don't have the elephants and we don't have the lions, but it's a very, very lovely little park. Myself, I will be here until I die, I guess, because I don't think I want to go anywhere else, because I love it here. And my wife's laughing, you know, in the background. So, I think people should try to come here to find out really what this lake is, because it's not just a muddy puddle as people think. It's a very nice place, and it's got a lot of potential in terms of developing the area, horticulture and infrastructure. So I hope we can do something together with the local people to improve the place and to improve the environment, really. I mean, to make it more friendly, user-friendly, because heretofore this place is undeveloped in the terms of that nobody has ever grown vegetables. In most of the land around here has never been touched with a spade or a fork. Nobody's ever grown anything. So there's a lot to be done. I do painting, and I am very much into the act of making sure that imagery is readable to other people. It's one of my important things in painting. One of the important things to me is that the observer, the viewer, my audience should be able to understand what's going on in a picture. So this particular painting is about an event which took place. It happened last year when the president of Uganda decided that he was going to steal some of Kenyans' territorial land, but then the Kenyans said, no, we're going to have to find out where exactly the borderline is between Uganda and Kenya by doing a marine survey. So these people came in from the survey in their big boat, and I had to go in my small boat to collect them from the boat. So it was at 9 o'clock at night, the moon was on the water, and it was an extraordinary light assemblage, with the light up underneath the canopy of the big boat and the searchlight shining across my little boat, and it made this visual image which I think is quite unique. And so
to me, I have to be fed with visual stimulus to create an image. And so things which often happen at night, like night fishing, night scenes, they're also very interesting to capture in paint. So this is really, it is the end of the marine surveyors, the Kenyan marine surveyors. They went out and they surveyed the line, the borderline, and then when they'd finished their job, they had to take the ship back to Kisumu, and I was asked to go and collect them from the big boat, because the big boat couldn't touch the ground, it couldn't come to the beach. So that's the story of that painting, and I think it's very encouraging for me to see that people like it and respond to it, because it means that I get a confidence from that in my work to continue. So I also do, I'm very much into colour and what colour can do visually, spatially, for the retina when the observer's looking. And the painting is so much to do with colour relationships and the structure of the painting. And for me, a painting should be like an easy chair. It should be something you relax with, you see into it, and you get a lot from it, rather than something which is jumping off the wall at you and shouting obscenities. I don't think that is really my cup of tea.
You can see on the board, the backing board, Mr. Jagembe just drew at six sixers. Very nice, very amazing. At one, four sixers in a row, in one row. Very amazing. He beat seven in a knockout. That was a knockout.
It was complete.
And I was only needing a double one.
He was only needing a double one.
Nice. So I'm the champion.
Yeah.
I'm now the reigning champion. So you want to take me on? Karibu.
Beat him up.
Oh, they got the generator working. So then we can...